Fournette, Fournette goes airborne. He's in. Touchdown, Jaguars.
Tip and intercepted by Ramsey to close it out.
It's over. The Jacksonville Jaguars have pulled off the upset of the playoffs.
Oh, the Jacksonville Jaguars and their first-round picks. What a roller coaster it has been, probably since 2012, with the first-round selection where the Jacksonville Jaguars select, and most, if not all of them, have not worked out to the favor of the team. But there have been some exciting first-round selections. For example, last year when the Jags drafted Josh Allen, I was very, very excited, and I think that's a guy that the Jags will have drafted that will pan out and become a very excellent player and a very excellent playmaker. You know, guys like Blake Bortles, Dante Fowler, Jalen Ramsey, some of them were busts, Taven Bryan, some of them were busts, some of them just did not want to be here, but today what we're going to be doing is talking about the 2020 NFL Draft, and we're going to talk about the top five most realistic players that the Jaguars might select at the 9th overall spot in the first round. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, this is five players that the Jaguars could select with the number 9 overall pick. Coming in at number 5, we have Jeffrey Okuda. Jeffrey Okuda has been mocked to go as high as the 3rd overall pick, so that's why I don't have him very high on my list. But the Jaguars have been in some scenarios, and the NFL draft has seen some scenarios where players that weren't likely to fall will fall. Prime example, Josh Allen. Josh Allen last year was supposed to go 3rd overall, ended up falling to the Jacksonville Jaguars, where they were drafting, and they drafted an absolute stud. The same thing could happen to Okuda. Okuda would instantly make the Jaguars secondary a lot better and really bring in a playmaker that can start his rookie season opposite side of Trey Herndon. Trey Herndon's also a guy that the Jaguar community, you either love him a lot or you hate him or you don't even want to give him a chance. So if Jeffrey Okuda comes into the situation, balls out, plays as well as he did in college, then this is going to be a guy that Jaguar fans and Jaguar management will be very excited to have on the team in 2020. Coming in at number 4, we have Jerry Jeudy, wide receiver out of Alabama. The Jaguars are in desperate need of playmakers, and they need to have enough playmakers on that field in order for Gardner Minshew to succeed. You know, if you're going to come into 2020 with the expectation of Gardner Minshew being your quarterback, and he did make do with the guys that he had around him last year, like Keelan Cole, D.D. Westbrook, DJ Chark, but adding another playmaker to an offense that really needs him is never going to hurt, and that's why I think Jerry Jeudy is a common selection at the 9th overall pick in a lot of mock drafts and for a lot of fans. I think, you know, giving him an outlet man, giving him a wide receiver at the caliber of talent that Jerry Jeudy has, he's the second rated wide receiver in this year's class, you know, first or second. I've seen him go both ways, first and second. Him and CeeDee Lamb are kind of competing for that top spot as the wide receiver prospect heading into this year's draft. Now, I think the Jaguars, personally, if they're going to try and select a wide receiver, they should do it with their 20th overall pick and try and get a guy like Ruggs. But Jerry Jeudy is a very realistic possibility for the Jaguars at the 9th overall selection, so that's why he comes in at number 4. Coming in at number 3, we have another cornerback by the name of C.J. Henderson. I have seen this go both ways in the Jags community. Some people really love him, some people really hate him. Some people like the idea of selecting him at 20, or like the idea of selecting him in the second round. But as the days go on and the draft continues to get crazier and crazier, and you know players are shooting up big boards, players are just developing into their own and becoming more and more first-round talents, C.J. Henderson's one of those guys. C.J. Henderson's a guy that might not be there at the 20th overall pick. And if the Jaguars are really serious and they want to address that cornerback position to kind of, you know, pair somebody with Trey Herndon in order to rebuild this team and, you know, make it an above 4-12 squad, then C.J. Henderson might be the selection at 9. That kind of leaves the door open for number 20 as to who the Jaguars will select. I personally don't think the Jags are going to try and take a chance on C.J. Henderson, but it's a total Jaguar move, and I could definitely see it. But I personally don't like this move. I don't like the selection. I'm not going to hate it too much because I think Henderson has a load of talent. But if you're going to take a corner in the top five, in the top 10, I think the only corner that's worth doing that for is Okuda, especially if, you know, guys like the number two ranked guy I have here and the number one ranked guy and number four and five are still on the board. You should not be trying to select CJ Henderson. But it's a move that I can see the Jaguars doing, so that's why he comes in at number three. And coming in at number two, we have Mekhi Becton, or Becton, whatever you want to say, from Louisville, the offensive tackle. Personally, I think the Jaguars have a lot of holes on the defensive side that they should really address before getting an offensive lineman. I know a lot of people think very differently than that. They think they want some guy to either replace Cam Robinson and move Cam Robinson inside, or they really desperately want an offensive lineman early in the draft. I think that's a 20-pick thing. I do. I think if you're trying to, you know, at number 9 really reach and try and find somebody to improve your team right away, you need a guy that's going to be a starter right away, no questions asked. I think Becton is going to have to compete with guys like Cam Robinson to get that starting spot. And as a 9th overall pick, I'm not a fan of it, but he's going to be one of the better players available. He is raw in the trenches. He's one of the best offensive tackle products in this year's draft. Obviously, there's going to be some teams that are going to be drafting some other offensive tackles, but if there has been a deep class in this year's draft, it's the offensive tackle position, and the Jaguars are in need of an offensive lineman. I personally just don't think we should go at the number 9 overall pick, but again, I think it's likely, and that's why Becton comes in at number 2. And coming in at number 1, and the player that I want the Jaguars to draft, and the player I think is most likely going to end up in black and teal, is Derrick Brown, defensive tackle. The Jaguars have struggled against the run for the last 2-3 years. Even in 2017, the team really, really struggled against the run, and they need a guy that's a true nose tackle or a guy that can plug up holes and stop the run. Derrick Brown is one of the few guys that are on this list, the exception, I guess most of them, actually. He'd be one of those guys in the first round that would be a day one starter. I mean, he'd come in and he'd be a part of a defensive line that is currently under a rebuild, but he might be one of the better ones out there. He might be one of the better defensive linemen that the Jaguars are going to have trotting out to that field opposite of Josh Allen. And I think that if he's there at 9, that's a no-brainer. I don't want the clock to wind down to 2 minutes. The Jaguars should select Derrick Brown, no questions asked. And that's who I think the Jaguars will draft in the 2020 NFL Draft. So Monday through Wednesday, we're going to be dropping some draft content for you guys, and until, I think it'll be Wednesday night, we'll drop our full first round mock draft. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. Make sure if you haven't already, click all the links down below. You can like me on Facebook at Troop Talks, follow me on Twitter at Troop Talks, or follow me on Instagram at Trey Vaughn Pixley. Also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, click the bell icon to get notified every single time I drop a new video. We also have membership on the way. Make sure you click join to get exclusive Treeb Talks content. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. And as always, you guys have a great rest of your day.